In this video, I'll be doing some molarity practice problems. So question number one, how many moles of NaCl are in 0.15 liters of a 0.2 molar solution? So because these problems involve some algebra, it's always good to start with your equation and just checking off what you have and what you're asked to find. Because if we're going to have to rearrange, it's better to do it when it's just a formula than to plug in and then try to rearrange. So we are given 0.15 liters, that's our volume, and we are given 0.2 molar. That's our molarity. So what we're looking for in this problem is how many moles. So we're going to have to rearrange and get moles all by itself before we can plug in. So to do that, I'm going to multiply by the reciprocal of 1 over liters on both sides, cancel out liters on the right-hand side, and redraw. So this is the formula I'll be plugging into. Because I have my liters, I have my molarity, and I'm looking for moles. So now I'll go ahead and do that. And now plugging into a calculator, my units are moles, and I've showed 2 sig figs, both here and here, because I had a limitation of 1, 2 sig figs from 0.15 liters, and this had 3 sig figs, so my least was 2, so that's what I had to replicate in my answer. So my final answer for this problem is 0.030 mole. Next, what is the volume of a solution with 88.5 moles of sugar and a molarity of 15.321? So again, just start off by checking off what we have, what we're looking for. So we are given the moles, we are given the molarity, and we are asked for the volume. So now I have to rearrange this so I have liters all solved by itself. So getting liters out of the denominator, rearranging, and now getting liters isolated. This is my final formula I'll be plugging into. Liters is isolated, that's what I wanted, and I have my number of moles and my molarity. So now I can go ahead and plug in. And plugging into a calculator, and again checking sig figs, I had 1, 2, 3 for my number of moles, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for my molarity, and that's why I'm only allowed to show 1, 2, 3 for my final volume. So 5.78 liters is my final answer. So now doing a problem that's a little bit more difficult. This is how teachers usually start to make molarity problems a little bit harder than the last ones we just did. What's the molarity of 245 grams of H2SO4 dissolved in 2,552 milliliters of solution? All right, so in this question, we're asked for the molarity. That's our question mark. And right now we have grams. So we can see in our formula, we only have moles and liters. We don't have grams. So right now we can't plug this into anything. We also have 2,552 milliliters. And this is a very common test question. Your teacher will give you a problem where your volume is not in liters. And so this molarity equation is very specific. This is only liters. So we can't plug this number in as is either. We're going to have to convert. And so this is really a conversion problem and then a molarity problem. So for 2,552 milliliters, that's more straightforward. We're just going to convert milliliters into liters. And then if you remember from learning about moles, we have 245 grams of H2SO4. And whenever you learned about moles, you probably also learned how to convert from grams to moles. So in this case, we don't have our check marks yet for moles and liters, but we have pathways to get to those check marks. I'll have to convert grams to moles, and then milliliters to liters, and then I can plug in like I did in problems 1 and 2. So it doesn't matter which conversion you do first. I'm just going to pick the more straightforward one. I'm going to go ahead and convert milliliters to liters first. So to convert to liters, we have to know that 1,000 milliliters equals 1 liter. And now we can set up our given number as a fraction, and we can multiply by our conversion ratio that we have up here. So we want to cancel out milliliters, so milliliters has to go on the bottom. So this whole left-hand side goes on the bottom. And then that means that our right-hand side goes on top. So now this cancels out, and when I divide, I get 2.552 liters. And so now I have one of my check marks. Now all I have to do is find the number of moles, and then I'll be able to plug in. So to convert in between grams and moles, we can use this conversion chart. In this problem, we're going from grams to moles, so we're going to have to follow the arrow that takes us there. We're going to have to divide by the molar mass. And so before we can do that, we have to have the molar mass. So plugging in my atomic weights and how many of each element I have in my molecule, remember I'm doing this for H2SO4. (98.077) is my molar mass, and remember this is in grams per mole. And so in my calculation, I've been pretty loose with sig figs. I'm not thinking about that yet. I'm not going to think about any sig figs until the very end of the problem. All I'm kind of doing is I'm looking up at my original problem and I'm saying, okay, I have 1, 2, 3, 4 sig figs, 1, 2, 3, 4 sig figs. So I don't want to make my molar mass less accurate than the sig figs I already have. So I made sure when I was pulling in all of these numbers from the periodic table that I made sure to use at least 4 sig figs just so I didn't lose accuracy with something that I was creating. I want to have the measurements that I was given in the problem be my limitations. All right, so now I'm ready to divide by the molar mass and get my number of moles. And so before we do that, I'm a big advocate of doing double checks in our heads. And remember, the molar mass is what 1 mole of our substance weighs. So we now know that 1 mole of H2SO4 weighs 98 grams. So already we can see, oh, we have 245 grams. That's just what the problem said. So we should expect our answer to be over 1. We should expect it to be over 2 because our molar mass of H2SO4 is 98. That's about 100. And so 2 moles of H2SO4 should be about 200. And we have even more than that. We have 245 grams. So with that kind of double check in our head, we should be getting some answer that's more than 1 mole, even more than 2 moles. Now we can go ahead and divide. Again, not caring about sig figs yet, I get 2.4980 mole. And so my units for this, grams canceled out, and then moles flipped up from being on the denominator of the denominator to being all the way up and in the numerator. And so now I have my second check mark. I have the number of moles. So now finally, I'm ready to plug in. So before sig figs and units, I have 0.97886. And now let's go through and just do a sig fig double check. So I have from up here, 4 sig figs. From up here, also 4 sig figs. Now just checking my work really quickly to make sure I don't have to change anything. My conversion fraction does not change my sig figs. I made sure to pull in all atomic weights that didn't decrease my number of sig figs. So it looks like 4 sig figs is my limitation. So that means I can round to 1, 2, 3, 4. I have to round up. And my final answer is 0.9789 molar. All right, hope you enjoyed this video and happy studying. Hey, I hope you liked that video. Please feel free to subscribe, click around and watch my other tutorials. And as always, happy studying.